Hey guys, it's Saga from TechWorks, and I'm back with another episode of the best Android apps. In this video, we take a look at some of the Android apps that you guys should definitely try out. All of the apps mentioned in this video are free, and links to all of them are in the description section. The first app on this list is Blacker, Dark and AMOLED Wallpapers. This is an app with a very good collection of HD wallpapers with inky blacks in them, especially for your AMOLED displays. You get a nice user interface, and it allows you to download, share, and set the wallpaper right from within the app. You can also browse through various categories of wallpapers, and there are a lot of them. Next app is for all you TV show lovers out there. It's called TV Time. With this app, you can create a custom TV show calendar for the shows that you like. It keeps a track of the shows you are watching and where you left off and so much more. When you install the app, you need to first select the shows that you are currently watching so that it can tell you when the next episode of a particular show is airing. You also get personalized recommendations based on the kind of shows that you like watching. And there is more. You get a dedicated community section where you can interact with other like-minded people who love watching the same shows that you do. So TV Time is definitely a must-have app if you are a TV addict like me. Next up, we have Split Screen Creator. With this app, you can make shortcuts to instantly launch two apps in a multi-window mode. Now you don't have to launch one app, then go to the split screen mode and select second app. Split Screen Creator makes this a one-tap process. I usually like to scroll through my Twitter feed and watch a few YouTube videos at the same time. So I have this shortcut on my home screen. To set it up, just go to the widgets, place the split screen on your home screen, and then pick two apps that you want to run at the same time, and you are done. Just a note, this app only works for the devices that are running Android 7.0 and higher. I saw the Pixel 2 smartphone and loved the live wallpapers on it. There is a way for you to get those live wallpapers on your device. You have to download the Google Wallpapers app from the Play Store and install an add-on APK file on top of it. I will leave links to both the apps in the description section. Once you have installed these apps, you will get the beautiful library of live wallpapers right in the Google Wallpapers app. There are some really good live wallpapers to choose from. I especially like this marvelous marble, which shows your location from space with real-time clouds and lighting data from weather.com. If you try this app out, let me know which live wallpaper you like. Next up, we have the first and only game in today's list. It's called Fingertip Balance. It's a simple game where you have to balance a weight on your finger for as long as you can. As you go along, the handle will shrink every 10 seconds, making it even harder to keep your balance. There is nothing more to do in this game, but it's a nice little way to kill some time. Try it out. Then we have an app called Notin. With Notin, you will never forget little things anymore. It's an easy way to store notes or reminders as notifications. The reminders don't pop up, ring, or alert you in any way, but they just sit in the notifications panel and keep on reminding you. Just open the app, start typing, and hit the plus button to move it to the notifications tray. To delete these notifications, just swipe them off and they are gone. Next app on the list is Meteor. With this app, you can test out your internet connection speed and also check the performance of some of your favorite apps like Instagram, Netflix, and more. Meteor's speed test for app performance checks your Wi-Fi and internet connection quality. This way you can rest assured all of your favorite apps are performing well, so you don't have to waste time on annoying delays and slow connections. Finally, to wrap things up, we have Launch Board. With this app, you don't need to scroll or search through your app drawer to get to a particular app. It's like the spotlight feature found on iOS devices. Most of the time, you know the name of the app that you want to launch. So instead of scrolling through the app drawer for it, just open Launch Board, type the first letter of the app, and get to it. This can save you a few extra swipes. You can even have the Launch Board widget right on your home screen to make using it even faster. You can even long press on a particular app and mark them as favorite so they are available at the top whenever you access the Launch Board. It's a nice little app, try it out. So those are all the apps that we have for you in this video. Let me know in the comment section which one of these did you enjoy the most. Please hit the like button if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to the channel for more quality tech videos like this. You can also check out some of the other videos on this channel. This has been Sagar, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Take care.